So in this video, we're going to explore why Coulomb's law is so very important when we're thinking about the structure of atoms and the stability of atoms. All right, so just as a quick reminder, we said that Coulomb's law is a potential energy, right? It's the form of potential energy that describes the interaction between two different charged particles. And it's roughly calculated by taking the charge on one of the particles times the charge on a different particle divided by the distance between them. So if we're thinking about two particles, a red particle and a green particle, we can assign charge to each of these. Let's say my red particle has a positive charge, my green particle has a negative charge, and they're plus one and minus one. And the distance between these two is the radius. So then my potential energy in this case would be proportional to the charge on one particle, which is plus one, times the charge on the other particle, which is negative one, divided by the distance between them, which is radius. And in this case, the potential energy ends up being negative one over a distance. So when two particles that have opposite charges interact, the potential energy is negative. And that's really important. What this tells us is that when oppositely charged particles interact favorably, the potential energy is negative. Okay? So let's apply this to atomic structure. So I'm going to stick with this same color code here, right? So positive charges will remain red, negative charges will remain green. And I will go ahead and have neutral molecules, neutral particles as this purple color. Okay? So we know that the structure of an atom has protons in the middle. So let's think about one proton and one neutron in the nucleus of an atom. Okay? And we talked about in this shell model, Bohr's model of the atom, that around the nucleus we have electrons floating around in orbit. So I have a green particle, which is an electron that has a negative charge floating around the atom in this orbit. And Coulomb's law applies to this because the nucleus has a positive charge due to the presence of the proton. The electron has a negative charge. So if we understand the distance between these two, right, that's our radius, then we can calculate or we can come up with the energy associated with stabilizing an electron on a nucleus. Right? So in this case, our potential energy is going to be proportional to a charge of plus one times a charge in our electron of negative one divided by that distance. So it's going to be a charge or a potential energy of negative 1 over r. Okay, let's see how this changes if we change the makeup of our atom. Okay, let's say we now have a helium atom. And let's specifically say we have a helium 4 isotope. Right, so remember, this is the mass number. The 4 is the mass number. Helium has two protons. So we have two protons in the nucleus. Four is the mass number, and that's the total number of particles in the nucleus, so the other two must be neutrons. Okay, and we don't have any charge written here, meaning that this atom must be neutral. Okay, so when we think about this orbit where the electrons go, we must have two electrons floating around this orbit. Okay, so applying Coulomb's law again. Let's focus on specifically this one electron here. And let's compare how favorably or how well this electron is interacting with a helium nucleus relative to how well this electron is interacting with the hydrogen nucleus. Right? So up here we had two nuclear particles, one proton, so this must be a hydrogen 2 isotope. Okay? So in this case, the distance is the radius again. And let me just tell you that when we're dealing with two atoms that are this similar, the radius is really, really similar. So hydrogen and helium have similar atomic radiuses. Okay? Let's think about the charge of the electron. Okay? So the charge on our electron, this is still negative 1, right? The charge on an electron is still negative 1. But the charge in the nucleus has changed. We now have two protons, so the charge in the nucleus that this one electron feels is now plus 2. And that's going to influence how well this electron is interacting with the nucleus. So in this case, our potential energy is going to be related to a charge of plus 2 times negative 1, that's the charge of the electron, divided by the distance. So in this case, our stabilizing energy is negative 2 over R. So an electron interacting with the nucleus of helium interacts with a more negative Coulombic potential, a more negative potential energy than an electron interacting with the nucleus of hydrogen. And that's really important. The more negative the potential energy, the more stable the interaction is. Okay, so using Coulomb's law, we've figured out that we can predict how favorably or how well an electron interacts with the nucleus of an atom. And if the radius is really similar, then having more protons in the nucleus will make a more stable, a more favorable interaction. So let's say we have a lithium 5 isotope. Lithium has an atomic number of 3, so we have 3 protons. A total mass number of 5, meaning we must have 2 neutrons in here. Okay. And let's now say that we have 2 shells, okay, 2 orbits. Right? So these first 2 electrons go into the first orbit, but the second electron is going to go into this outer orbit. Okay? And this outer orbit is further away from the nucleus than that first orbit. Right? Again, we're thinking about this like planets. So this is like saying planet Earth is further away from the Sun than Mercury. Right? So in this case, the radius has changed, and that becomes really important because remember in Coulomb's law, the potential energy is equal to the charges divided by the radius. So the further away we get, the less negative this potential energy is going to become. So this electron in the second orbit is not interacting with the nucleus as tightly as electrons in the first orbit. So to quickly summarize, the two big variables that can influence the stability of an electron in an atom are the distance that the electron is from the nucleus. That's the radius, and that's dictated by the orbit that it's in, and also the total positive charge contributed by the nucleus.